this year, and our committee is on a schedule to complete the markup on the legislation by Memorial Day recess. President said he wants this, he wants legislation, he wants us to move as quickly as possible. He said this is an opportunity to move and we ought to take this opportunity.
But he didn't say to do it this year. So.
Well, we said we're moving it this year and he didn't object.
So what is your response to the chairman, to Henry Waxman? Is it going to be moved this year?
Well, I expect it is. There's no question that House Democrats and the president have been very open about their desire to pass the so-called cap and trade bill, including this national energy tax. And interestingly, today we had, I think, about 9 witnesses at our energy summit, Andrea. But the last one we had was actually a videotape of the president himself before the editorial board of the San Francisco Chronicle about a year ago. President Obama said that if his cap and trade bill passed, I think his phrase was, utility rates will, quote, necessarily skyrocket, close quote. And then he went on to say that those companies would, of course, pass that cost along to consumers. We thought that closing the testimony part of our energy summit today with the words of President Obama himself was a very effective way to make the point. The American people deserve to know this cap and trade bill represents a massive national energy tax, all in the name of global warming. And there's a better way. We can promote clean technologies. We can make a commitment to nuclear energy in this country for electrical generation. We can have a whole new all of the above strategy for energy independence. We don't need to pass a national energy tax on every household in this country.
And Congressman, the Democrats rebelled against the president on the Gitmo funding, on $80 million from the Defense Appropriations Bill. What are the Republicans going to do? Just sit back and sort of watch this become unraveled, or is there a fix for the Guantanamo closing money?
Well, you're going to see House Republicans bring forward a bill. I know that Congressman John McHugh and Pete Hoekstra and Eliana Ross Layton have built legislation that should come to the fore in a matter of hours or days that will create a very clear criteria to protect the national security interests of the people of the United States of America. We just simply believe that the president was wrong in announcing his intention to close Guantanamo Bay before having any idea whatsoever what to do with these dangerous detainees down there. And we want to ensure that no jurisdiction within the United States or any territory is subject to having to take these detainees. And the Republican alternative legislation is going to create real barriers to that happening that put the security of the American people first.
It's an area that Democrats and Republicans agree against the White House wishes. Let me ask you also just to pause a moment and give your remembrances of someone we really cared about deeply, Jack Kemp, an extraordinary man who had a different vision for the Republican Party than many Republicans and had his ups and downs but never lost his love of life and his embrace of a diverse population. Your recollections of Jack?
Andrea, thank you for that eloquent remembrance. You know, Jack Kemp was my hero when I became a Republican in my early 20s, and over the last 8 years, it will always be a joy to me to know that he and Joanne became personal friends of ours. He was truly a mentor to me. It seemed to me he personified that combination of a Republican vigorous belief in free market economics, in entrepreneurial capitalism. But Jack, as you alluded, also really understood the Republican Party's foundation and its commitment to Lincoln's ideal of equality of opportunity. He never lost sight of that. I've tried to embrace that in my own career, in policies that I joined Jack in supporting, even legislation that's before the Congress this year. I think as the Republican Party is finding its way after a couple of disappointing elections, I really believe as the nation, millions around the country mourn the loss of this good and great man, our party need look no further than the enthusiasm, the commitment to principle, the commitment to equality of opportunity and to values that was Jack Kemp.
Well said. Thank you so much, Mike Pence.
Thank you.
Thanks for sharing your thoughts, and we will be right back.